So, Rick, how do you invest around all of this now? We've got a payrolls report. We've got a sense for what the Fed's going to do on the 15th, an idea for where it might go in 22. What have you been doing, Rick?
So, by the way, I'll go back. I think Mohammed described it exactly right. You know, this is the point about things can break. And when you're late, you've got to think through that from an investment paradigm. What does that mean? The first thing that has to happen, the Fed needs to exit this QE business. And the question of how far they're going to go or how much they're going to go, they need to get out of the QE business. So the thought they're pumping more liquidity. There was a Tuesday. There were two injections of more liquidity into the market. That is crazy. So they need to get out. So, but what you have to do when you invest, you have to think about, gosh, we're now going to be in a lower liquidity period. We're now going to be what is going to be a more uncertain period. Quite frankly, there's an awful lot of patience that you need to bring to the equation. We've been doing that in portfolios. And so, you pull back on the high yield market, you pull back on how much equity exposure do you have? And you got to be a bit cautious. You know, you run higher levels of cash today. And then you look at areas, exactly like Mohammed said, there are areas that are now starting to come unglued. If you look at what happened this week around some of the tech stocks, some of the software companies, and by the way, some businesses that are really good businesses that all of a sudden people are, you have crowded trades in, people have to get out. That's the time you invest. So we're doing much more opportunistic investing. And I think you got to be a bit more careful than when you had immense liquidity in the system, a huge tailwind of growth. And now you just got a little bit of patience, a little bit more cash, and then be more opportunistic.